بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما أخرجنا من ظلمات الوهم وأكرمنا بنور الفهم وأنعم علينا يا عظيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي أما بعد All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and peace be upon his beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I testify that there is no God except Allah Almighty, and I testify that Muhammad is the Prophet and the Messenger of Allah. And my brothers and sisters in Islam, continuing the story of the great Prophet Musa alayhi salam, in which we left you with last week, the beginning of the preparation for the prophecy. How Allah Azza wa Jal prepared Musa alayhi salam for the great mission and the great job, the great responsibility of calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, preparing Musa alayhi salam to stand before the one that's after him to kill him, and that's the Fir'aun. And we mentioned how Prophet Musa alayhi salam went to Madian. In where in Madian he met Prophet Shu'aib, he got married to one of the daughters of Shu'aib in return of a dowry of serving or working for him for 10 years, 8 years minimum, and Musa alayhi salam completed the 10 years. And then Musa alayhi salam, after 10 years, he alayhi salam traveled from Madian to Egypt to meet again and unite with his mother and his family. And on the way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will choose Musa alayhi salam and inform him of his great responsibility that he is the prophet and the messenger of Allah, in which Allah had sent him to save Bani Israel. And this is where I want to highlight that Musa alayhi salam's main mission was not to call Fir'aun only, but to save Bani Israel from the oppression of Fir'aun and the people of Egypt, to save Bani Israel from what they have been facing, from the injustice and the oppression of Fir'aun and the Egyptians. And we mentioned that Bani Israel originate from Ya'qub, and Ya'qub, he had a son Yusuf. Yusuf alayhi salam was in Egypt, and Yusuf alayhi salam reached to the stage and the level of ruling the whole country. And then Yusuf alayhi salam invited his family to Egypt, in which Bani Israel lived under their brother Yusuf alayhi salam in a peaceful, happy, wealthy life. But later on, as years came, Fir'aun and the Egyptians did not like the presence of Bani Israel in Egypt. So the time twisted against Bani Israel. And now the Egyptians treat Bani Israel as slaves. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Musa alayhi salam to save Bani Israel from the injustice and the oppression and the transgression of Fir'aun and his army. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he told Musa alayhi salam, when Allah spoke to him, and Musa alayhi salam, as Allah mentioned him in the Quran al-Kareem, وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهُ مُوسَى تَكْلِيمًا, that Allah spoke to Musa many times. Taklima means many times. And Musa, he's been described as Kalimullah. Musa used to speak to Allah constantly, not like any other prophet, including Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They all used to communicate with Allah azza wa jalla through an angel or inspiration. But no one had the advantage and the opportunity to speak direct to Allah Azza wa Jal as much as Musa alayhi salam did. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He chose Musa alayhi salam while he was traveling from Madian to Egypt, on the way Musa alayhi salam, he got lost. And we mentioned the story how Musa alayhi salam, after he got lost, he was looking for someone to tell him and direct him the way to Egypt. And Musa alayhi salam, he saw a fire lighting up in the middle of a dark day. And Musa alayhi salam went to see that fire, and he told his family, wait over here, maybe there is someone around that fire that could give us direction. But it was Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who was preparing Musa alayhi salam, in which Allah told Musa alayhi salam, اخلعنا عليك إنك بالوادي المقدس طوى. Take off your shoes, you are in a holy place, الوادي المقدس, the valley, or the holy valley. طوى is the place, as the scholars mention. إِنِّي أَنَ اللَّهُ لَا إِلَٰهَ إِلَّا أَنَا. As Allah told him, O Musa, it is me, I am the Lord, that there is no Lord except me. فَعْبُدْنِي وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِذِكْرِي. So worship me and perform the prayer so you could remember me. And we mentioned the story how Allah Azza wa Jal told Musa and asked him, what's this in your hands? Musa said, it's a stick that I rely on and I follow my sheep and herd with. So Allah Azza wa Jalla told him, throw it, that stick then turned to a great snake that Musa ran away, that Allah told him, come back and grab it. And Musa grabbed it and came back as a stick as it originally was. And then Allah Azza wa Jalla told Musa, put your hands through your garment under your arms. And then he took it out and it was a glowing hand that Allah Azza wa Jalla showed Musa. It's Allah that's speaking to him, not anyone that's playing a trick on him. And then after Musa alayhi salam realized and recognized it's Allah, that Allah is addressing him, it's Allah that's speaking to him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then he told him, O Musa, idhab ila fir'auna innahu tagha. Go to Fir'aun. This whole thing that's happening, not because you're Musa, not because I want to show you miracles and speak to you, because you are Musa, you've got a job. There's a job from behind all this. And this is where we all have to understand that the prophets and messengers, what made them prophets and messengers? Not because they were righteous people and only that, because they sacrificed. Because they sacrificed, because they struggled, because they strived. A lot of us think that when we become religious, we start saying, why am I going through a lot of hard and tough moments? Well, the prophets and messengers did. You don't expect to go into the religion or walk into the religion and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes everything easy for you. How are you going to prove yourself to Allah that you're a truly believer? Allah Azza wa Jal tests you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts you through the trials and the tests at the end to stand up and say, ya Allah, whatever you put me through, I'm still a believer and I still stand by this deen. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Musa alayhi salam, اذهب إلى فرعون إنه طغى. Go to Fir'aun. He had transgressed. He went overboard. And the whole mission that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Musa, not only to call Fir'aun, but to save the people, or the Bani Israel, the children of Israel, from the transgression and the oppression of Fir'aun and his army. We mentioned how Musa alayhi salam told Allah azza wa jal, ya Allah, that these people are following me to kill me because I killed one of them. وَلَهُمْ عَلَيَّ ذَنْبٌ فَأَخَافُ أَنْ يَقْتُلُونَ. I have committed a crime among them and I'm scared that once I stand before them, they will kill me in return. وَأَخِي هَارُونُ أَفْصَحٌ مِّنِّي لِسَانًا. My brother Harun speaks better than me. And Musa alayhi salam had a problem in speech. He used to stutter when he used to speak. And that does not look good, a well presentation for a prophet. Especially the whole main thing that a prophet does is speak. And when a prophet stutters in his speech, it's not going to be accepted the best way. So Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose Harun to accompany him and also chose Harun to be a prophet and a messenger. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tells Musa alayhi salam, as Allah mentioned in Surah Taha, اِذْهَبَا إِلَىٰ فِرْعَوْنَ إِنَّهُ طَغَى فَقُولَا لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا لَعَلَّهُ يَتَذَكَّرَ أَوْ يَخْشَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered Musa alayhi salam and Harun to go to Fir'aun. And Allah told them, go to Fir'aun, وَقُولَ لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا. And speak to Fir'aun in a soft and a calming and lean way. Be lean in your approach towards Fir'aun. And this is Fir'aun, the worst of people. And Allah Azza wa Jal is teaching the best of people that in your way of dealing with others, you should always have the lenient and the soft approach. And this is also an understanding for us to teach us how to give da'wah when we deal with others, when we speak towards others, even non-Muslims. There's no one worse than Fir'aun. Fir'aun claimed to be God. Fir'aun claimed to be the creator. And Allah Azza wa Jal over all that, He told Musa alayhi salam, He told Harun alayhi salam, the best of people to speak to Fir'aun in a lenient, in a calm, in a soft approach. Then come to him and say, you are the enemy of Allah. Allah orders you to obey him and worship him. No, there's a soft approach. There's hikmah, there's wisdom in the way we call to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this does not only apply from Musa to Fir'aun, but applies to every Muslim. That when we call to Allah, idu'u ila sabili rabbika bil hikmati wal maw'idati al hasana. As Allah said, call to the path of Allah with wisdom. With wisdom, we call to Allah Azza wa Jalla with wisdom. We call to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with respect. We call to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calling people to the deen of Allah, not taking people away from the deen of Allah. So Musa alayhi salam and Harun said, قَالَ رَبَّنَا إِنَّنَا نَخَافُ أَن يَفْرُطَ عَلَيْنَا أَوْ يَطْغَى. They said, oh our Lord, we are scared that once we approach him and stand before him, he will kill us. Me and him are two people and this man has a great army. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what did he respond back to Musa? And this is not only to Musa, but to everyone that calls to Allah. Allah said, قَالَ لَا تَخَافَا. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid of Fir'aun or anyone like Fir'aun. إِنَّنِي مَعَكُمَا أَسْمَعُ وَأَرَى. I am with you. I listen and I see. I am with you. What's Fir'aun and his army going to do towards you when I'm with you? And this is something for all of us, my brothers. When we call to Allah, we are calling for Allah. We are calling to Allah. So Allah is with us. Allah is with you. And what would someone do when you have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with you? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَأْتِيَاهُمْ فَقُولَا إِنَّا رَسُولَا رَبِّكَ فَأَرْسِلْ مَعَنَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ وَلَا تُعَذِّبْهُمْ قَدْ جِئْنَاكَ بِآيَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكَ وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَى مَنِ اتَّبَعَ الْهُدَى. And this is the main mission. Allah Azza wa Jal told them, go both of you to Fir'aun and tell him that we are the messengers of our Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we command you to send Bani Israel with us. So that was the main job, that was the main mission of Musa alayhi salam. His mission wasn't to call Fir'aun to Allah only, but his main job, Musa's main job and main mission was to save Bani Israel from the oppression of Fir'aun. فَقُولَ لَهُ إِنَّ رَسُولَ رَبِّكَ فَأَرْسِلْ مَعَنَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ وَلَا تُعَذِّبُهُمْ. Don't punish them, don't persecute them. You went too way overboard in persecuting and punishing Bani Israel. قَدْ جِئْنَاكَ بِآيَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكَ وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَى مَنِ اتَّبَعَ الْهُدَى. And we have verses from Allah. We have verses and miracles to show you from Allah. And peace be upon those who follow the right guidance or the right path. Now Musa alayhi salam and Harun will go to Fir'aun. Now he is going to Fir'aun, one of the most powerful people on earth. One of the strongest people on earth. The king and over and above the king. He knows he wasn't only a king, but Fir'aun had stronger powers and authority than a king. He claims to be the Lord. But a king says, I'm a human being. Now this man thinks he's above that. Musa alayhi salam went to the palace of Fir'aun. To enter the palace of Fir'aun to speak direct to Fir'aun. So when Musa alayhi salam and Harun arrived, they arrived as normal people. And no one can remember Musa alayhi salam. It's been 10 years. When they arrived at the gate and the palace of Fir'aun, the gatekeeper refused entry for them. Who are you to come and see the Pharaoh? Who are you? What authority, what respect, what status? Do you come and see the king or you want to come and see the Pharaoh? So Musa alayhi salam said, go to the Pharaoh and say, we are messengers. We are messengers. So this gatekeeper went to Fir'aun and told him, there are messengers out there asking and waiting to enter the palace to come and speak to you. And back then there used to be a messenger, someone on the behalf of a king, someone on behalf of an emperor. So they thought those two are messengers on the behalf of some king or some emperor. But they were the messengers on the behalf of the greatest one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then they'll walk in and they stand before Fir'aun. And Fir'aun, he's the one that raised Musa alayhi salam. He knew that was Musa standing before him. And Musa alayhi salam will stand before Fir'aun. And then the conversation and dialogue starts between him and Fir'aun, in which Musa alayhi salam will start and say that I am the messenger of Allah, coming to guide you to worship no one but Allah, to take it away from the worship of the creation, to worship the creator Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to worship the true and real Lord, the Lord of the East and the West, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that created everything, to worship Allah azza wa jal, the one that created us. And Fir'aun, with his tyrants, with his pride, Fir'aun, la'natullah alayhi, with his pride, he says, there is no Lord except me. You come and say about a Lord, there is no Lord except me. And keep in mind, my brothers and sisters, that Fir'aun, he's not speaking alone to Musa alayhi salam and Harun. When people walk into the palace of Fir'aun, he's got people around him. He's got his maids, he's got his soldiers, he's got his ministers. So it's not just a dialogue between one and one, but there's people around present. And for Musa to stand before Fir'aun and tell Fir'aun to worship no one but Allah, this is a humiliation to Fir'aun. So Fir'aun has got to stand up and defend himself and say that he is the Lord.
All the prophets are brothers, and they represent the same message. What was the call of the prophet? What was his invitation? He was inviting to what? So the prophet said, "Oh Allah, grant your mercy, and the one who is tolerant if he, you know, if he sails, and one who is tolerant if he buys, and one who is tolerant when he seeks his rights."
In this program, Sheikh Abdul Rahman Damashkia presents Reminders, a bouquet of various reminders and admonitions that we need to strengthen our faith, taste its sweetness, perfect our acts of worship, and refine our morals.
Try to discipline them in the best way. Those daughters will be his shield. That means those will be the reason, the cause of his protection from hellfire. Because of what? Taking care of them. What you have in this life, no matter what you have, is less, and it is the Lord.
Huda TV wishes you and your family a spiritual and rewarding Ramadan.
He is the Lord. There is no Lord. I do not know any other Lord beside me. This is what Fir'aun said. He's telling people around. These people claim that they came from the Lord. I am the only Lord, and there is no Lord except me. And Musa alayhi salam will respond back in hikmah. Well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that created the east and the west. Allah is the one that created the heavens and the earth. Allah is the one that created us all. You don't have that capability. You know from yourself, you can't even resurrect your own self for you to resurrect anyone else. Now Fir'aun starts to threaten with his powers. He starts to threaten with his strength. Oh Musa, if you continue saying that there's another Lord beside me, I will lock you up and I will torture you and I'll execute you. So Musa alayhi salam, he remembered, إِنَّنِي مَعَكُمَا أَسْمَعُ وَأَرَى. Allah Azza wa Jalla told him, don't worry, I am with you. I listen and see what's happening. Who is Musa going to get scared from? Fir'aun? Let Musa be afraid from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Musa responded back. And Musa said, but our Lord, it's Allah, the one that created us. And he emphasizes on the point that he knows Musa. Musa alayhi salam knows that Fir'aun doesn't have the capability of. And people around are just watching. They're afraid. They are shocked. How could someone speak to the Pharaoh like this? They've never experienced anyone speaking anywhere near what Musa alayhi salam speaking to the Pharaoh. And then Fir'aun gets more aggressive. His pride becomes more into him standing before Musa alayhi salam to humiliate Musa. So Musa says, stop. Well, if you don't believe I'm a messenger, I have some verses from Allah. I have some miracles to show you. So Pharaoh says, then let us see what miracles do you have. So Musa alayhi salam will throw his stick. And that stick, a normal stick, that you could pick it up from any trunk of a tree, or pick it up from anywhere in a farm, or anywhere in a forest, or anywhere in a from any tree or from any garden. That normal stick will turn to a massive snake that they mentioned that the tongue of that snake, one part was touching one roof, the other was touching the ground. Everyone around sees that snake, gets scared and pulls away. And then Musa grabs it again and it comes back again as a stick. They saw that scene. And everyone knows. And he had magicians that were dealing with him. That's not magic. But Pharaoh still got that pride. Still got that aggression. That wants to enforce himself that he is the Lord. And then Musa puts his hands. He was tanned. He puts his hands under his arms. Takes it out and glows like a moon. And then he puts it in again and comes back normal. And people are watching that. And Pharaoh realizes that now people are really sympathizing with Musa. People now are listening to Musa. People now are really considering to say, he's not the Lord. The Lord is the Lord of Musa alayhi salam. So Pharaoh with this aggression, Pharaoh with his pride, but now he's afraid. He's seeing that people are pulling towards Musa. And at the same time, he saw something from Musa, he got scared. This man has got a snake. Maybe he led that snake on man to eat me during the night. What would happen? So Musa alayhi salam, calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Fir'aun, he stands up, he says, this is magic. Like every other magic that we see and experience. And at the time of Musa alayhi salam, was a time of magic being spread. People used to respect magicians. And magic was something that's very well common at that time. So they, Fir'aun start to play around with the minds of people. And this is just magic like every other magic that we have and experience. And we have a lot of magicians out there. And if you really think that what you have is coming from God, then let us get our magicians. And Musa said, okay, put the challenge forward. Now Fir'aun is challenging Musa. But the reality is not challenging Musa. He's challenging Allah, the Lord of Musa. And no challenge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept any challenge. But at the end, it's always going to be Allah Azza wa Jalla, the one that will wield that for challenge. And Musa alayhi salam will say, then put that challenge. We accept that challenge. Let's assign a day. And then Musa alayhi salam will say, we'll call for that day. Yawm al-Zina. It was a day that they celebrate. And Musa alayhi salam, he wanted that challenge to be open, where everyone can see and attend. And Fir'aun accepted. And now Fir'aun, he's facing a big challenge. And now Fir'aun is looking for every magician. Every magician in the town. Where Fir'aun gets as many magicians as he can. And Fir'aun himself, he had his own magicians in which he had raised himself. He taught them magic. He made them grow up on magic, live on magic. And then he gathered them. And the day came in which Musa alayhi salam to challenge Fir'aun and his magicians. And Fir'aun will speak to his magicians and say to him, what's the day today? Is it the day of success? Are we going to win today? And then they said, فَبِعِزَّةِ فِرْعَوْنِ, by the glory of Fir'aun, that made a promise by the name of Fir'aun, as how we make a promise by the name of Allah. They said, by the glory of Fir'aun, إِنَّنَا نَحْنُ الْأَعْلَى, we are the ones that will be high. We are the ones that will win. We are the ones that will succeed. We are the ones that will destroy Musa. But what do we get in return? This is the thing. What do we get in return? You want us to destroy Musa? You want us to humiliate Musa? We've got our tools, we've got our spell, we've got our magic. But what are you going to give us in return? So Fir'aun, he said, I will make you from my closest people. You'll be from the hierarchy people in Egypt. I'll give you wealth, I'll give you strength, I'll give you authority, I'll give you what you want, but humiliate for Musa. Destroy Musa. They thought it was easy done. And then the day came. Well, people attended the place. And it was an open challenge. The people, the Egyptians, Bani Israel, all gathered in a place in which Musa alayhi salam and Fir'aun had agreed on. And Musa alayhi salam, along with his brother Harun, will come forward. And Pharaoh will come with his army and his magicians to stand before Musa alayhi salam. And then the challenge will begin, and everyone's watching, and everyone's listening, and everyone is there to experience the great experience of their life. And then they ask Musa, "Oh Musa, do you want us to throw our sticks and ropes, or do you want to throw before?" So Musa said, "You throw. You begin. You have the first shot." And then the magicians would throw the sticks, their ropes, and whatever they had, as many of them, and their sticks and ropes will turn to snakes just floating around everywhere. Everyone got scared, including Musa alayhi salam. He got scared when he saw that scene. All these snakes just running around. Musa got scared. Didn't expect to see something like that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentions, "Tukhayyu lahum a'yunuhum." This is something that their eyes is seen. In other words, it's something they just see with their eyes, but the reality, there's nothing there. It's the sticks and the ropes. And here Musa, as it been narrated, Jibreel will come to Musa and say to him, "Oh Musa, Allah is beside you. Allah is with you. Throw your stick." And here Musa alayhi salam will throw his stick. His stick will turn into a massive snake that ate all the snakes that were around. Who saw that? Not Musa alone, not Fir'aun alone. The magicians and all the people living in Egypt saw that with their own eyes. One man against many. One stick against many. That one snake ate all their snakes. Now, the magicians know the secret of the trade. When they saw that snake turning from that humble stick of Musa alayhi salam, coming from this man, Musa, who looks like doesn't know anything about magic, they are the ones in that trade. They know the secret of that trade. As a carpenter will know this man when he speaks is a carpenter or not. So they are the magicians. They are the ones who deal with magic. They saw Musa. He's not a man of magic. They saw that stick and what that stick turned to. That's not magic. So they were the first people to prostrate to the Lord of Musa. And they said, "Innana amanna bi Rabbi Harun wa Musa." We believe in the Lord of Musa and Harun. They were the first people to resort to Allah. They were the first people to repent. And who's there, Fir'aun? "Oh, God used to stand by me. Now you believe in the Lord of Musa? You were here for me." So they said, "This is not magic. This is from Allah. No way this is magic. That's not. He's not a magician. And what he threw, that's not magic. This is coming from someone above. And there is no one more. There is no one above Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." They're all prostrated. They're all prostrated to the Lord of Musa and Harun. They all became Muslims. 1 minute before that, they were against Musa alayhi salam. The minute after that, the other followers of Musa alayhi salam. One prostration. One prostration, my brothers and sisters. And what's that one prostration? That one prostration, my brothers and sisters. That one prostration is equal to 1,000 prostration of many of us. That one prostration made those magicians strong and firm. That Fir'aun threatened them and he said, if you do follow Musa, if you do surrender to Musa, I will execute you. I will chop your feet and your hands and arms and crucify you in the middle of the desert. So they said, "La dair, do whatever. We are the followers of Musa." Subhanallah. Within 1 minute, my brothers and sisters, these people became so firm in their belief that are willing to sacrifice their life for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where we have been prostrating to Allah for years and we can't even sometimes sacrifice a little sacrifice for Allah. I want you to compare the prostration that you prostrate to Allah with that one off prostration of the magicians of Fir'aun. That one prostration changed their life, that made them firm and strong, made them firm and strong, that they're willing to sacrifice their life, and no doubt they were crucified by Fir'aun. They were tortured by Fir'aun before that. Their hands and arms and feet were chopped. They were the first people to believe in Musa alayhi salam. Now the Fir'aun seen that scene. What's happening here? These people were supposed to be with me. Now they turned against me. And not only this, many people saw that scene. Now many people are saying, we believe in the Lord of Musa and Harun. We don't believe in Fir'aun anymore. And Fir'aun is seeing all that. Musa is just getting strong and stronger and more followers. And people are just following him. And Fir'aun wants to kill Musa alayhi salam, but he's too afraid of him. He's too scared of him. He saw things that he's never seen in his life. And the followers and the soldiers and the ministers of Fir'aun will come to Fir'aun. And they're saying to him, how could you leave Musa alone calling to his religion? And the people of Bani Israel are following him. And there's all these Egyptians are also following him. And you just let him go. And Fir'aun is too afraid to go near Musa alayhi salam. He's seen things from this man that he's never seen in his life. He's scared that he goes near this man. This man will end up will make his ending on it. Which it is coming. His ending is coming very nearby. And Musa alayhi salam will go back to Fir'aun and say, oh Fir'aun, free Bani Israel and send Bani Israel with me. Enough is enough. You've tortured Bani Israel. You've treated them like slaves. Now I want you to free them and send them with me. How many people were from Bani Israel at that time? There was over 600,000. So it's a full nation. 600,000 Bani Israel, they were all treated to be slaves. And Musa alayhi salam will come back to Fir'aun and say, send Bani Israel, free them and send them with me. I'm going to take them out of the land. Just free them and send them with me. And Fir'aun will say, no, I'm not going to send them. And Musa will say, my Lord orders me to do so. And Fir'aun denies the Lord of Musa alayhi salam. And Musa will insist. And Fir'aun is too scared to go near Musa alayhi salam. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala start to torture Fir'aun and his people. Every time Musa will ask Fir'aun, send Bani Israel with me, Fir'aun will refuse. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send a punishment on the people of Egypt. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish Fir'aun and punish the people of Egypt. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, Allah Almighty, He says, وَلَقَدْ أَخَذْنَا آلِ فِرْعَوْنَ بِالسِّنِينَ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَذَّكَّرُونَ. The first punishment is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Fir'aun and the Egyptians go through a severe drought that they'd never ever experienced before. وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ, and reduce in fruits. The time of season where they used to get kilograms, hundreds of kilograms of fruits, that season will come, they only get few fruits. These are only the farms of the Egyptians. But the farms and the gardens of Bani Israel, no more fruits. This early drought that will come down to the Egyptians. But Bani Israel, everything is normal. And then Musa alayhi salam will go up to Fir'aun and say to him, Allah is punishing you. And He'll continue to punish you and your people until you free Bani Israel. And Fir'aun will refuse. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send another punishment on them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, فَأَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمُ الطُّوفَانِ. Allah will send a flood on them. A flood will come to them that will destroy all the houses of the Egyptians and the house of Bani Israel untouched. The water will come wherever there is an Egyptian house, will destroy it. And the house of the Israeli doesn't come near it. And Musa will go to Fir'aun and say to him, oh Fir'aun, release and free Bani Israel, or Allah will continue to punish you. You and your people. And Fir'aun will refuse. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send on them another punishment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent on them the locusts, in which the locusts came and into every single garden and every single house of the Egyptians. And the gardens and the farms of the Ibani Israel are left untouched. Musa alayhi salam will go back to Fir'aun and say, oh Fir'aun, free and release Bani Israel. Allah Azza wa Jalla will take this punishment away from you. And Fir'aun will insist with his tyrants and his pride to refuse to free Bani Israel. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send on them another punishment, the vermin, in which Allah Azza wa Jalla will send on them the little insects that wherever they go, in their food, in their clothing, in their houses, on their hair, in their farms, just full of those little insects that killed their life. They can't sleep because of it. Makes them so itchy and scratch. And the people of Bani Israel are normal. The Egyptians are facing this punishment and the people of Bani Israel are normal. So Musa would go to Fir'aun and say to him, "Oh Fir'aun, release and free Bani Israel and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take away this punishment." And Fir'aun with his pride, he refuses again. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send another punishment on them. Allah will send frogs on them. Wherever they go, there's frogs. Frogs in their pillows, in their mattresses, in their toilets, in their food, in their farms, in their houses, in their gatherings. Frogs are just popping out of everywhere. And the people of Israel, they can't even see any frogs around. Musa will go back to Fir'aun. Oh Fir'aun, free Bani Israel. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take this punishment away. And Fir'aun with this pride will refuse to act upon the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the last punishment in which Fir'aun had nothing else except to surrender. And he surrendered, but at the end he came back with this pride again to refuse to free Bani Israel. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَأَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمُ الطُّوفَانَ, the flood, وَجَرَادَ, the locusts, وَالْقُمَّلَ, the vermin, وَالضَّفَادِعَ, and the frogs, وَالدَّمَ. The last punishment was the blood. What's this blood? Bani Israel, they were living normal life. But the Egyptians and Fir'aun, when they come to drink water, they fill it up. Once they fill it up, it's normal water. Once it gets filled up, it turns to blood. They have normal water, it's just the normal water. They come near it, turns to blood. They come to drink it, turns to blood. They come and have a shower with it, turns to blood. They come to deal or touch this water, turns to blood. And Bani Israel living their normal life. The water stays normal water. But the Egyptians and Fir'aun, whenever they get new water, that water turns to blood. They drink blood. They have a shower with blood. Their whole life was just revolving around blood. What kind of a life is that? So Fir'aun, he reached to his peak and he surrendered. For Musa alayhi salam came to him and said, take Bani Israel. And then moments after that, Fir'aun with his pride turned again. He says, no, I'm not going to free Bani Israel. So Musa alayhi salam fled with Bani Israel during the night with Fir'aun and his army, and the Egyptians did not know about. And this is the story that inshallah.